then second quarter, St Mary's sparked a little bit, but it's still not half.
A little too late. It's a 10-goal margin right now. Veal jumps early and misses it. Foss takes the bouncing ball, gives it across to the running Lavaz, who's tackled by Veal, of all people. And bouncing ball comes at Bolsh. Did or ducked his head there, did Devlin. Gave it out to Lavaz. Looks like he started on the ball. Benny Lavaz goes towards goal. Good start to the St Mary's. Get the first one. Only took 47 seconds.
Great start, but what should be, what I'd be impressed if you were coaching Colac, Lockie Veal,
oh,
tackling Lavaz,
yep,
from behind,
yep, that's
after he's just gone up for the hit out. I mean, yep, they've come out after half time, and even though the goal was kicked against them, they've still got the right,
yep,
attitude.
Absolutely, yep. A bloke like Lockie Veal, you'd say, oh, he'd never catch Lavaz. As I mentioned, Lavaz into the middle.
Need to put a couple of people in the middle with some pace, obviously.
Up it goes again. Van Janen wins it, only as far as Kelly. Gets it on the boot quickly. Listens the target, bouncing ball, traps it. Then goes to ground, dishes off the handball. Goes to Seal, off the left. Quick answer, oh, you bet it is.
You see him just shaking the head? Just nodding the head saying yes.
Gee, that was, that's a quick reply.
It was.
The St Mary's one took 47 seconds. That one took 23.
They just can't seem to do anything wrong. You see there, Wilson got tackled, went to ground, still handballed it out, and it just bounced up perfectly. His teammate runs on, kicks a goal.
What are you looking blank for?
Well, I think the goal to Lavaz might have just been one out of the blue, because I think that tackle was impressive. It meant they're on. I think if they're on,
yep,
after what they did in the first quarter, it should just go forward.
Seal got a bit of the ball last week, and when he got it, Milky broke into his rendition of Kiss by a Rose.
Did he? Good, solid. Seal. Back in the middle, Van Janen against Veal. Veal's probably had the better of him today at the moment, but Van Janen with a tap. Out to Lavaz. Linton's the bottom of the pack, so is Foss. Foss gets it forward, only as far as Simpkin.
Oh.
Simpkin didn't know what to do with it, really. Veal wins it. Eventually gives it out to Mahoney.
No, it was Embry.
It was Embry, was it?
Yeah. that's McCarthy.
It's McCarthy. There's a few M's floating about, and it comes out of bounds just up from Colac's.
We don't say it very often, but the umpiring's been very good today.
Ex-player.
Just to, well, there you go. He knows a bit about
massive difference.
Often when they're ex-players, they know what to...
Exactly. Totally agree with you, Tonks. And Nick.
Veal wins the tap. Doesn't win the tap, just grabs it and kicks it long on his left. Goes into the middle of the ground. Taken by, that could be Mahoney. It was Mahoney.
Kicks long. It was Rowan Nickus.
Comes as far as Learson, who's wrapped up.
Surely that's a free kick.
Should reward that, because he made every effort to just push on once he got tackled. And Quinane will take the resulting free in the
young under-18s boy.
First time he's been stopped today, Learson.
He's actually quite good.
So Quinane's in the goal square. Doesn't know what to do though. Decides to go to the outer side. Lavaz is the target. Bounces up for him. Decides to tap it on. Putting out his hand as Carruthers wants the free kick. Kicking ball to Finn Chisholm. He's back, so there was nothing wrong with him. Up and under kick though. You see Simpkin, who take a very good mark there. Lockie Simpkin.
You related?
Yeah, one of the brothers.
Yep.
Comes over, his kick's intercepted by Van Janen. In turn, Hamilton picks it off to McLean. Juggling mark in the mud.
When I said related, he's obviously related.
One of the brothers, he is,
all,
yeah.
They'd all be related up there. But the, was he your first?
Yeah, be careful.
Was he your first relative?
All related up there. Take you down.
It was
there.
Either Alex Tajani or who's the other boat? Max Blake told me that he reckons he's the best of the lot.
Is he really? So Nick Lynch has got it. He kicks long, looking for his cousin in Learson. Learson couldn't grab it. Kicks out. Taken by Embry. Handballs to his cousin in Bolsh. Bolsh kicks it long and fine. Looking for Nick Lynch. No.
Josh Eddy across to Ryan Granville. Granville puts it out to the stretching Hamilton. On forward go. Oh, Snowden chose Alex Adams. Clean pair of heels, and he takes a chest mark. Oh, Snowy, be 38 metres. The man of marks, sorry, be 38 metres out. He'll kick from about 45.
Should get the distance pretty easily, but a lot of people have been struggling kicking
to
this
push end. It across to the right, doesn't
it?
Yes.
Interesting to see how he goes here. So in comes Snowden, right on from the 50. And actually, didn't quite get the distance. He had the accuracy this time, but just didn't make the distance. So he got punched through
fished
on the line.
Through by Veal.
And putting it in the rushed column.
The jock asked me why we have rushed goals.
Well, exactly. I probably agree with that as well.
Comes down to Smart, the kick out. He goes to Kelly. Kelly picks it up, gets around one. Now he doesn't know what to do with it. So he goes back to Simpkin. Simpkin off one step, goes out, finds his teammate. That's Marnie. He goes forward. Oh, Carmody goes up. Can't take the mark. Down to Quinane. What's he going to do with it? Down the line he goes up. Oh, misses McGregor. Goes over. Misses McGregor. He missed McGregor.
Mrs. McGregor.
Schoolboy is having a bit of trouble over there. I'm just trying to work out if it was me that's wrong of him, but I think it should be 3-6, shouldn't
it? Yep, 3-6.
Yep. So they got 2-6. So
apparently down at Colac, when you mentioned Jock, Skinny Hay was there last week, ready to go, but he had a better offer to have a few drinks in the crowd. Is that correct?
Skinny didn't get my email.
Claims he didn't get the email. He had a few drinks in the crowd.
Do you reckon that they did get it?
Strange claim. Strange claim. Comes out the back here, half forward line for Colac, St Mary's, and it's rolled out of bounce in front of Banjanin and Lavaz. It'll be thrown in Banjanin versus Veal.
Skinny is one of the good people. It's a wonder he didn't line up to come in here today with you.
No, you're on the drinks again today.
Comes out to Banjanin, goes back and gets it. Kelly's in there wrestling with the footy. Hasn't actually made an effort to get it out, but this umpire isn't going to ping him, and we will have another ball up right on the back of the square, or the front of the square, or whatever, depends which way you're going, I suppose, isn't it? It's the St Mary's end. Veal smashes it forward into the path of Linton, who taps it forward, then goes and gets it again. One in the back, surely. No, nothing doing, says the umpire. McLean gives it to Lavaz. Lavaz gets around one, but he can't get around Linton. Linton steals the footy. He's Gornsky. Gives it over to Learson. Learson, wobbly old kick. McGuan marks, but they take it all the way back because it was Linton's free kick.
Linton plays on with a handball. Tries to balk his Simpkin, goes onto his left, and as Nick Brown said, what'd he say? The best.
The best of the lot, apparently.
The best of the lot. To a playing AFL.
That's a hit, yes.
Best of the lot. Comes into the square. Up go. I don't know how.
Embry nearly there.
He could have nearly done it from about three deep. Learson handballs off to McGuan, and McGuan surely got smothered.
Touched, I reckon. Yep.
Touched to McGuan. We'll give it to him as a point. He's kicked 2-4, according to me.
Yep. Spot on, because it agrees with me, so it has to be spot on.
And it's going to be kicked in by St Mary's. Scoreboard, by the way, we're not sure. 13, it'll be 13-7 now. 7-8.
Yep,
13-7.
3-6.
To 3-6. Kicked in, out to McLean, and that's where they go every time.
We said just get hold of him, because you know that's where they're heading.
So McLean's got it, pocket for St Mary's. Wants to go in short to Eddie. Does. Eddie's got it, half-back flank. Grenville provides his second lead in as many minutes.
He dodged nobody just then. Did you see that?
He's still pointing, trying to let him know, and he finally gets it to him. He had to go to him. He was letting him know everywhere that he was clear. Did a lot of effort to get that, and he gets it, Romain.
He actually dodged a shadow.
Romain kicks it along to Banjanin. Hit the front of the pack, couldn't get it down the front. Good roving by Darcy. Darcy handballs to Nolan. Nolan kicks to a leading Chisholm, and that was actually quite a good play.
It was, yes.
Good to see Chisholm came back on. It looked like an ankle injury.
Good play, and Chisholm at same spot again now. Snowden didn't make the distance from here, so it might be...
Actually, getting back to Snowden, the man on the mark was 38 metres. He had 12 metres he could have gone up. He kicked it from outside 50.
Chisholm just spots it into Snowden, and that is a ripper mark from really deep.
That deep.
Good kick in the end. I think he just spotted where he was, and Snowden now this time will make
the
distance.
He'll make the distance.
From 20, it's just a matter of how the accuracy is, and in fact... I'm that confident I'm marking it down.
Wow, he's kicked two straight so far.
Third.
Two straight.
2-1, has he?
No,
two straight.
Snowden marked it down, so he better not miss.
He's marked it down, all right. Can he put it straight over the goal umpire's hat? We put the other one down as rushed, in case you're wondering there, because it was fisted through by Veal.
So Mary's fourth. He's kicked three, Snowden, and Lavaz has got the other one.
Mm-hmm.
They go to 4-6, trailing by 9 goals over to Colac, 13-6 around the grounds. Milky,
at this early stage, Bell Park 6-13 to 3-5, that game's over, I reckon. Grovedale 5-4-34, South Bowen 2-11-23, so that's a very interesting stage. Lara 8-8-56, North Shore 2-3, St Albans and Leopold, still that point difference, and the Newtown St Joey's, no score change there either, which is interesting. Three games haven't started yet. Back in the middle with a bit of a wrestle. And
well, in the AFL around the grounds, Hawthorn 7-12-54, 5-9-39 leader Bulldogs, and GWS 6-3-39 trail Essendon 8-3-51.
Veal wins it, knocks it down only as far as McGregor. McGregor gets on his bike, puts it at the top of the square, going back was Keast. Then did he throw that?
He did.
I think he might have got pinged or banned down, and there's a massive loss.
That is a big
massive loss to St Mary's.
They're not sure who to
Snowden left to go on the ruck, and then they got a hole at centre forward then, haven't they?
Yep, they're just letting him know now as Chisholm's going to come in, and he's within distance here, 30 metres.
Just telling Condi you have to go forward, so looks as though he'll take the message to Snowden that you have to go on the ruck, son.
Yeah, that's not good for St Mary's. When you're 9 goals down, your big ruckman goes off.
Chisholm gets the applause of his teammates, so he puts and their fifth goal on the board.
Would you refer the goal or Banjana?
Banjana's still on the ground, I would have thought.
Yeah. So Chisholm kicks their fifth. 5-6 trailing now by 8 goals.
Weren't as confident with that one. Didn't put that down.
Oh, I was a bit worried about the big banjo going down.
Yeah. A
bit distracted.
Oh, we wouldn't want to go down. It's ladies' day. He does dress himself up, has the shirts open with
sort of the
chest, loves all that chain sort of look. And ladies' day would have been great for him, and now he's gone down. Maybe he's gone down because he wants to get in.
Let's get the ladies early. Back in the middle we go. Oh, Snowden gives away the free kick because he went early. And it's a free kick to Veal. Field. Low ball goes straight to McLean at centre half back. Andrew McLean chips it out to Will McGregor.
Went wide then.
Yeah, very wide. He in turn goes to Freddie Stepman, who goes over to Foss. Foss to Eddie, who's St Mary's best, I reckon. He goes down to Romaine. Romaine bounces off the big chest and keeps going. Boundaries growing.
Lavars wants to come on. He's just waiting on someone else to come off here.
That's usually the case. What happens?
Yep, exactly right. Not happy. He's not happy.
Well, Foss into Kelly's back. Nothing doing, says the umpire. Learson's in there, trying to drag it out. The umpire, look at the umpire, ran the other way.
Learson's right. Yeah, he got up, not happy with. Not happy.
Freddie went after him.
No free kick there either.
No, just umpire knew there was nothing much in it.
Free kick. This time against Snowden again.
Yep, two in a row. Veal didn't want to kick that one. Besides, it's getting a bit hard, a bit heavy underfoot now. Taken by Colak and through Monaghan. To Kelly. Kelly to Adams. Adams across, and this time him flying through.
Gone.
The ball.
Play on! Play you're on. Kidding me!
He'll play another free in a minute to make up for it. Eddie. Handball's off, looking for Snowden. They're all in. No one can really control it that well, and the umpire's saying,
he's got his head between his legs. Sure,
yeah, this time I'll ball it up. As finally it comes off, and LeVar says, well, I've been waiting here for a long time.
Nolan's got a bit to say about that.
Nolan's pointing, so I couldn't get off.
Down to Simpkin.
It's Snowden versus... Oh, he's shepherding again. The same thing happened again. He didn't pay three in a row, though. Snowden at the bottom of the pack. Kelly, of course. Kelly nearly gets it out, but Etherton jumped in front of him.
Hell, Mitch.
They're saying, Learson eventually gets out and goes for touch.
That's exactly what it was.
We're going, ball up. It's all a bit willing in there at the moment. The umpire will pay a free in a minute just to clear it up, you'd think.
This young fella.
Physio.
The controlling of the umpire. He just perhaps needs to pay a free to open it up. Veal smashes it. Fekos, what can he do? He misses it. Free kick there to Darcy. Nothing doing, says the umpire. Comes out to Sammy Cardinal. He gets hands over to Kelly, who misses it. Foss gets out the handball. No, across the Monaghan.
There's the free.
There's the free he was going to pull out.
He's giving it
to Foss, isn't it?
Yep.
Of the Justin kind, not the Hayden kind over at St Joey's.
Giving it to Foss. Oh. Carmody.
Freddie must be a bit of a nuisance because that's the second one that's bowled him over.
Yeah, no, they're just letting him know. Romaine.
Romaine.
Great mark. back quickly and kicks it to the pocket. Not the best kick really for Chisholm. He couldn't really, he just had to sit under it.
And hurt him again by the looks.
Oh, he just wasn't happy with having to sit under it. Yeah, comes out to Bolsh. Bolsh handballs backwards into Embry. Embry to go across the ground to Learson, who's played a good game. Learson plays on. He didn't even realise the guy was on him. Just thought, I've been by myself all day. No one to be near me.
He didn't see Fazio.
Did not see him at all.
The old Fazio.
He honestly thought he had that much of space today.
McGregor just ran over there then, just pat him on the head. I think, well, you might want to get a kick before you start doing that.
Yeah, I thought perhaps, well, he hasn't even kicked the goal yet.
Yeah, perhaps teammates could have either blocked Fazio or let him know that he's on his way.
Nah.
Just left him do it.
He thought he had that much time. And in he comes, 20 metres out, straight in front, Fazio. He couldn't miss this. He'll do his best, but he goes through for a goal, and that's his first, but it all...
All of a sudden, that's three in a row to St Mary's, isn't it?
Yeah, more importantly, it is their sixth. So they now go to 6-6, 42... No, I don't know how the scoreboard got to 42 that quick without just 4-6. 6-6, 42, and they trail theirs. Now, they were 10 goals down there, now 7. And it is.
This is exactly what happened last week.
Sorry, yep.
They just got off to a fly start, Colac, and then just sort of grinded their way to the end, and it looks like it might happen again.
15-minute mark, yeah. Third quarter.
Up we go again. Oh, Veal scut in. Ben Jenner back out there. Good to see, boys. Loose ball. Foss trying to crash his way through. Can't pick it up. Kelly's at the bottom of the pack. Ball's in the mud. Chisholm gets it off by hand. Oh, across to Hamilton. Across to Foss. Chisholm's got it again. Skating in the middle there. Alex Adams traps it, goes wide, away from the glue pot, goes out to Chisholm, rules on this, and then he comes back to Van Janen. Van Janen goes out to Simpkin.
Just had report from Rob Condy that Van Janen had to go off because he was being raffled at the ladies' day. He's back on now, it's all okay. Went for a good price and it was good cause.
In case you
know, raffled as well, wasn't he? Oh. Won a golf bag, haven't I?
Did he? Thrown in, it was Van Janen who just went for a big prize in the ladies' day in Veal. Veal at the bottom of the pack. It's a lot of packs developing in this third quarter, and it'll be a ball up. 16 minutes in, Colac lead this one by 7 goals. Don't you worry about what the scoreboard's telling you. It's 7 goals.
Up it goes. Veal, who's done a very good job, pretty much lone head other than the odd rest with McGuan. Bouncing ball into the path of Rowan. Knocks it down into the path of Smart, is it? Yes, it is. Who's wrapped up in the tackle. Umpire just watching. They're all saying, you know, holding the ball. The umpire says, nah, give it to me. No prior. Have a ball up on the outer side with the, obviously the scoreboard doesn't pay any attention to us because they ain't listening. 6-6 it is, isn't it?
Yep.
Fisted down. Oof. At the back of the pack. On hands and knees was Seal. Comes across to... That was Devlin, I'm pretty sure. Oh, but it's McCarthy who tries to keep it in play and unsuccessfully, but goes over the boundary and will have a throw-in.
Well done then by Scott Condy.
You're a bit of a Condy fan, aren't you?
No, Scott Condy had a struggle in the first quarter. He's got run around a lot in the first quarter. He's just settled back into the game now.
Veal knocks it, then goes off the deck, gives it to Smart, who handballed it to Lavaz. Lavaz gets it down. Loose ball, Adams. Now puts it out for the Lekos. Pinter's pizza. What can he do? Picks it up, gets around one, gets around two, but gives it across the back to Adams. Bouncing ball to Learson. Over to Oban. Oh, good hands across there to McCarthy, who in turn comes to Jake Carmody. Carmody's got the other Jake. But in the goal score, being held onto, surely on that occasion was Kelly. No, nothing doing, says the umpire. Nearly ripped his jumper off.
I think everyone saw it by the umpire.
Yes. And Will, it's being repelled here by... No, Kelly goes back. Never give up, this bloke. Has another crack at ground level. Dishes it off to Chisholm. He's wrapped up. Free kick going against Kelly.
I thought he was going to deck the umpire.
Did they rip him off of the medal? What else are they going to cost him?
Wasn't happy then. Was not happy.
Comes bouncing ball, finished up, I think, in the arms of McCarthy again. And wrestle on the centre wing. Three different, I think there's three, whilst we said the umpires are good, I think you've got three different types of umpires. This bloke in the middle here seems to just ball it up all the time. The young fella seems to do the circling. Then you got our old mate up this end who seems to know what's going on.
thrown up.
It's Veal, and it has most of the day. Veal versus Ben Jannan. Out to Lavaz. Lavaz kicks, looking for Granville. Good mark to Romain, and plays on. He's away. Kicks it into goals, looking for Snowden, and drop one to take it.
Josh Eddy, great roving.
Great roving. That was really good play from St Mary's, and suddenly it's only six goals. It is now stepping four on the trot.
No, that's it. That's right now. 7-6. I've caught up.
And they're six goals straight down. They were 10. They've kicked four on the trot. Are they back?
Do you remember a couple of weeks ago when we recovering the game here, and I said they were a strong finishing side? But I don't think they're going to be quite strong enough today.
Well, Tony Betts back to six goals, the closest they've been all day. Although, I suppose at the start of the game when they were nil all, they were probably...
Who's that last one too? You put that down as...
That one was Josh Eddy. Yep.
Just then it was.
Just then.
Not that you're up with
it. They've sorted out their centre square, I reckon, St Mary's. I reckon that's been the big deal. Ben Jannan wins it. Knocks it down. Fazio over to Lavaz. Lavaz by hand across to Nolok. Gets a crook bounce, but good enough to go back and get it. Gives it over to Devlin. Little give out to Lavaz again. He's really lifted this quarter. He has a bounce. He's going to have a ping at him from the pocket. He goes towards goal. Oh, he's got another one.
Tell you what, he hasn't been their best, Lavaz has.
Oh, I'll tell you what, Lavaz kicked two this quarter. He's been the difference in the quarter. And all of a sudden, they have five goals down. If you rocked up at half time, you'd think they were well in front.
Yeah, exactly.
So they are playing much better football here, St Mary's, at the moment. They've kicked five on the trot.
So it's still a 31-point lead, so still plenty of work to do, but geez, it's at least they've made a bit of a game of it.
Five goals, 30 points. Oof. We're back. It's the St Mary's boys back in town. McGuan into the ruck on this occasion. Up he goes early. Nothing doing, says the umpire. Play on. Linton's in there. He tries to knock it clear. Ball's dragged back in. Umpire says we're going to go through all of that again.
Should be 31, I think.
Should be 13-7.
Yeah, 13-7.
All over it you are now.
It is. Ben Jannan wins it. Knocks it only as far as I think that's Monaghan. Wrestling forward. He gets one high, says the umpire. Good, actually, very good decision, that one. Lent over the top of him. Ben Chisholm. So it's Monaghan in the centre circle. Little short when he goes. He's put it over Carmody's head. And gets a free kick for the chop of the arms. Against Hebbard. Boy, I thought he was thought when he went over he was going to...
Hebbard's letting him know. He said, you realise Milky knows my parents?
Jake Carmody ignores his other Jake in McGuan. Goes to centre half forward. Oh,
good mark.
Good mark. That's young Quinane who's taken that. Dishes off to his teammate in Darcy. Darcy goes long, but it looks like... Oh, surely that's a free kick to Simpkin.
Yeah,
got legged.
Sort of need him, didn't he?
Yes. So he's going to take it. Gives it over to Kelly. Unloads. Goes long. Seal goes up. Oh, this goes up with one hand. Back to Quinane. Quinane round the body. Where's it heading? Heading over the fence. And Snowden's happy with that, that he's gone to touch. 31 points or 30 points, is it?
31. 13-7, 8-6 here, and it is 23 minutes in.
Oof.
To the third quarter. What was...
Certainly not impossible, but it looked improbable at half time, didn't it?
Well, it looked no chance, basically.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, there's people backing them.
Best bet. Is that what you're saying?
Yep.
Grovedale's 11 points up on South Bowen.
Ran off with the ball.
Looks like it. Lara's 50 points up on North Shore. Leopold have gone out to a 14-point lead over St Albans. Newtown have hit back. They're 4 points up on St Joey's.
That's why you're going quiet.
And Bell Park is 20 points up on Geelong West.
Got a bit quiet, isn't it?
Yeah, I wonder why Phil got a bit quiet.
Don't you two start.
Oh, and he's hit the bench. Not happy.
So they've had to get the ball returned. Ben Jannan misses it. Goes to his teammate there in Devlin. Carruthers tries to crash his way through. Loose ball. Up and under. Oh, good mark.
Was a good mark.
To Will McGregor. Back with the flight. He goes, oh.
A throw.
the marketing attempt finished up with Finn Chisholm, but I tell you, good work there from McCarthy.
Well done from McCarthy.
Kelly has to try and take the mark, goes over to Oban, gets the 1-2 from Kelly. Kelly goes too long, and it finished up with McLean.
Not the best kick down from Kelly, did the hard yards.
Yeah, the disposal's letting them down in this quarter, the Tigers. Goes up to Blacksall.
He's got Foss leading. LeVar's absolutely buggered coming to the bench. He's had a big quarter.
Blacksall just unloads. It's all Colac here. Embry goes back. Takes with the easiest of marks, uncontested. And has a look around, Embry. Short kick. Goes to Jake McGowan.
Is he in range?
Yeah, he's only 80 out.
McGowan. He's looking. He's looking. Kicks it long.
Kicked
Did
it
he have a 65. Shot? He might have a shot. Gets tapped out, and Linton decides to get back in the game. Dropped out of touch, but it's just gone and rolled out of bounds.
Straight off the side of his boot. Very uncharacteristic.
He doesn't feel those, actually. He seems to either kick it at an unbelievable goal or hit the target, or he just misses the lot.
They'll fix that over summer. Now, he's got... It is 25-minute marks, and Colac would be really wanting a goal, but for St Mary's point of view, they'd be all the hard yards here. They wouldn't want it to go undone with a late goal to Colac.
Oh, good trap there by Cardinal. Dishes off by hand, goes back to Kelly. Ooh.
Got a lot of touches in the last few minutes, Kelly.
Crashing his way through on that occasion. Oh, Jake McGowan probably could have let that go, I reckon, almost.
So, when that one in the rush column?
Yeah, yep. You can put that in the rush column. And they go to 13-8. And they lead St Mary's 8-6. It's going to be brought in here. Don't know if that is Devlin this time.
It's Will McGregor.
Yeah, Will McGregor.
Yeah.
St Mary's would love one more before three-quarter time. This time they kick long. Looking for Banjanin, but over the back is
Bolsh.
Bolsh kicks it in and finds Falekos. Falekos is away. Plays on, kicks it to the top of the square. Who's there? He's got...
He got one high, surely.
He'll pay that. You'd
no, he didn't.
Oh, he didn't pay it. That was round the neck. Didn't pay that either.
Not the second one.
The central paid it.
The young fella.
This guy, how he missed the first one, has got me beat. How he missed it, has got me beat.
Missed them both, but the young fella said, I'll overrule that, thanks, mate.
This is Sammy Cardinal. I'm not sure if you're still taking my niece out or not, but anyway... The first one was to Patrick Seal.
Sam Cardinal. Come in and he kick a much needed goal for Colin.
Oh, he doesn't.
Doesn't really get near a shocking kick, and it's a point. They've had a couple of little wasted opportunities just in the last dying minutes of the third quarter. They go to 13-9, leading St Mary's 8-6. And it is 27 minutes in.
1-3 to 6-1. Falekos gets it over to Linton, the danger man, goes around the body, top of the square.
Oh, well done.
Oh, fast, but it's Falekos!
They were peppering, and I just had the feeling they had to try and hold him out, but they just couldn't. Falekos gets the goal. They're 14th.
Three Pinkies pizzas for everyone tonight.
It was the important goal to just stem the tide or just relax a little bit. So it's 14-9, Colac, and they lead.
Well, it was Falekos that handballed it to Lynch, wasn't it? Then he followed it up.
Kicked it.
14-9 to 8-6.
I like the guy on fight down there. He nods his head, nods the goal. It doesn't keep him guessing.
Yeah, ask him out for tea. Back in the middle, Snowden versus McGowan. Come through, Foss. Snowden trying to pick it up. And it's taken by Foss. No, Falekos has wrapped him up. Wants to try him.
That ball.
It's travelled 20 metres.
And it's just a little handball. I reckon no one handballed it. You take it.
No, I'll get rid of it. And it's tapped out this time by McGowan in the middle with Snowden. McGowan just rides on top of Eddie. And Eddie, you say, I'll take the free there. Umpire Nacho. Can't pronounce it, he's like Guanacci or something
like that, yes.
So taken by Eddie. Eddie just kicks in hope, really. Romain! He just punches this time. Up goes Learson. Romain's got it. Grenville just throws it. He's got a kick in this game, big fella. Goes down long, and it is going to be taken by McCarthy. You'd think he'd clear. 234s, battle it out. Cardinal and Hamilton.
Oh, good pickup, whoever that was. Hamilton. Lynch.
Taken by Learson. Learson just handballs, but it's going to be a ball up this time, surely.
Where's the umpire?
Yeah, well, you're talking about players that might switch sides during the off-season. I reckon Romain Grenville should make his way down to the Melbourne Rebels, the way he goes about it.
He attacks the ball very hard.
He'll be a handy rugby player.
Going balled up. Blonde versus Snowden. Over the top, Eddie, third man up. Looks at Lavaz. Lavaz had a great quarter. Could he kick his third for the quarter? Yes!
Oh,
hit the post.
Big stick.
Deserve that. He's had a great quarter.
It's almost like a set play, that, wasn't it?
To go.
Oh, over the top. No mark there to Rowan. And the ball rolls over the banner from the kick out. And we'll just have a boundary throw in. About 70 out from the St Mary's goal. Been a great quarter from St Mary's. Six goals to the Marys this quarter. Ball spinning in. Snowden over the top. Gives it down to Fazio. He's dispossessed. Comes out, picked up by Jake McGuant. Little short kick to Jake Carmody. The Jakes are sticking at it. Thought if he had open then on the run, but he decided no, we'll go to Cardinal. Cardinal dishes over to Kelly, who's under pressure. Wall one high. Didn't get the free kick. Goes, there's the siren.
The bell.
Oh, good quarter of footy.
Kelly's copped about four around the head today and has not got a free for one of them.
Yeah.
Three-quarter time of St Mary's here. Colac lead 14-9. They kicked 2-3 that quarter to a coming back St Mary's who kicked 6-3 to go to 8-7. So they, Colac now lead this one by 6-2, 38 on track today. Linton wanted a big quarter and Lavaz just had a ripper in the third quarter.
16 points southbound trail Grovedale. And St Joseph's 5 points down on Newtown. Spashed in the wrong direction by Veal, but good use by Simpkin. He's been really good today for the Tigers. Leading out is Timmy Hibbard. He gets hands on it. Goes down into the direction of Freddie. Freddie drags the footy in, but it's fed off by the Tigers. Comes up. Is that McGuan or Kelly, that one there? That was Kelly. Loose ball. Romain comes out, Linton, he dispossessed, then kicks it off the deck. Benny Lavaz goes back and gets it, and Linton again, great tackle, Gornski!
That's a great tackle.
Just his running ability, just continues running, has a bounce, comes into the centre of the ground, no one chasing him, puts it in front of Jake McGuan, who doesn't quite make it. On hands and knees is Josh Eddy, dishes off the handball to Kelly. Kelly now gives it over to Jake Carmody. He's dispossessed, slung in the tackle. Oh, friendly fire there. Linton cop one from Kelly. Comes out to Monaghan. Goes towards goal. Oh, McLean hits the goal post. Minor score.
Linton's nose wasn't broken. It is now, Milky.
He got it from Kelly. I saw it.
Yeah.
Friendly fire.
Still worried. He's just looking over there, not happy.
Looking forward to watching Linton on TV next year.
There you go, see?
This used to.
Comes in, kicked in by St Mary's, but it's only his phone. The umpire said, you ducked your head, but I'm going to pay it.
Your mate didn't, but the young kid up in the forward 50
overboard
did.
Overboard again, and I'm going to give it to Cardinal. This is
Monaghan. There's no Monaghan.
I've said Monaghan as well.
Yeah, it's Monaghan.
Monaghan.
Majority rules.
From 50. Tried to get as much distance as he could. Didn't end up getting none. Banjan tried to claim the mark. Gives it off to Hibbard, who we just all know. Who knows their parents. Comes out to Linton. Linton gives it to Monaghan. Monaghan goes
Monaghan.
For
Gooses.
Kelly. Kelly kicks it long into the pocket. And Learson's there, but so is Kinane. Oh, don't tell me Learson's marked.
Great use of the body.
Great mark in the pocket. Plays on
the nana.
Point.
And the umpire says not good enough. That's a point there, Kane.
Post was in the road again.
It's going to be kicked in for St Mary's by Blackstone. They've kicked 2 points this quarter, Colac. They go to 14-11. They're leading St Mary's 8-7.
Great man, Dogger Ryan. Dogger Ryan. Comes going behind us anyway. Goes. Kick out. Oh, clear them all. Straight over Hibbard's head, who goes back and gets it. Gives it to Josh Eddy. Hands out. Oh, did he get one high there, Kyle Devlin? Yes, he did. Free kick.
Goes wide to McLean. McLean, half-back line, plays on immediately and looks for McGregor. McGregor's got it, just in front of O'Bourne. So McGregor, half-back flank for St Mary's. Goes inboard, 3-on-1. Oh, just clears it. Lux of Fortune comes over here to Darcy. Couldn't get it. Taken by, that's McCarthy. And it comes right to the Street Surfer Plus. Could have nearly touched it, Milky.
Yeah, just about.
Get a touch and we'll get a good look at the umpire throwing it in here. Look at the serious face.
Good technique, isn't it?
Yeah, good serious face there.
Just see Ben Jenner rip the handy.
Yeah. Tried to do that, but Veal ends up with the ball. Goes out. Still all wrapped up. Banjanin's now got it all rammed into the ground. The umpire said, that's in the back. You can take it free there, big Banjo. Raffled off at half time with the ladies. Gives it off to LaVars. Big third quarter.
He's done it again. Banjanin's done it again.
Oh, yeah. I just thought he had to get back in there. There's a lot going on in there, Banjo. We want to get back into the ladies' day. The
train. He's kicked it in the player stand. He's missed everything.
Meanwhile, the play did go on as we were worried about who was coming.
He has kicked it from the social rooms into the past player stand.
Long kick. No
missed
score.
Everything.
No score resultant. Free to Colac.
Lynch brings it into play. Oh, 2-on-1 here. Seal good and mark. Foss. A good mark to Justin Foss. Had 2 to beat. Just good use of the body again. His brothers couldn't quite make it, did he?
So... Justin Foss.
So this is a better kick than Grenville's. Grenville's one of those players. You either kick your 4 or 5 and put on a show, or you'll just can't do nothing right.
Mm. Romain's got a point to his name so far today. Romain Grenville. Who are you pointing at?
Just the notes on.
We did change.
Steve.
He's got the time.
In comes Justin Foss. Puts it wide into the pocket.
Got it.
The mark, isn't it?
Snowden
almost, but wrestling with it was Lynch. Ball at ground level. The umpire's just letting it go, and it's just stacks in the middle of it. Had plenty of that today. Comes out to Embry. Gives it over to McCarthy. McCarthy goes down. Oh, picked up by McLean. He's tackled, dispossessed. Trying to crack his way through. Oh, he handed that away. Young Foss. Foss coming off here in front of us. So it wasn't him that handed away, and we'll have a ball up almost in the centre of the ground. Learson, we've got a message about Learson. He's giving him best player or something. Or are you doing your votes? You're doing your votes on the way at the door.
I'm going.
Up they go. Freddie Stepner, he gives it over to Kelly. Kelly puts it in the Jake McGowan direction. 1, 2, misses it. Then goes back and gets it. Good enough. Off a step to the left boot. Out into a foot race. Flekos. Also, Jake Carmody. Oh, gets a crook bounce. Trying to crack his way through with Blaxel. Will McGregor helps him out and kicks it straight down the line. Bolsh can't mark it. Over the boundary line. Right here in front of the street surfer bus where Luke Bath, wouldn't they love him out there, gets hold of it.
You only get a vote if you got an L today.
If you got a L in your name, you're a chance. Lockie Veal's one of them. He gets in there, knocks it down. Oh, trying to crack his way through on that occasion was Devlin. Then, the ball they're calling is on hands is Cardinal. He drags in underneath. They're going to ping him. The umpire's circling. No. Have a ball up. Who's that last up? Oh, Josh Eddy. He's been good. He's up there. He'll be in there best for sure.
14-11 to 8-7 at this stage. Start of the last quarter, around the neck, you'd think. Not paid.
Not paid.
Right in the back in the middle. Kelly's there as well.
Can Bath be feel like you just want to go in there and get the ball?
Yeah.
I think that's why we might have asked the umpire that. Earlier before the game. Might have been his arm cast.
Oof.
Was it?
Tapped down to Kelly, hit dispossessed, comes over to Etherton. He in turn goes to Nolan. Nolan goes after the footy again. Round the body he goes. Snowden's the target. Oh, got a shoulder done here. I think it's Farzell or Hamilton. I can't tell him from front on. Out it comes to Linton. Puts on the afterburners. Then dishes off the handball to nobody. Goes to his lookalike in Oborn. Comes out the back. Seal gets over the top of Eddie. No free kick happening here, boys. And it comes out, I reckon that's Devlin that's being wrapped up. They're letting it go. Seal out the back. Finn Chisholm, he's dispossessed. Then he goes around the corner to Condi. Condi around the body. Embry takes a mark on the chest.
Looks like he's trying to pop Fazio's shoulder back in there.
Not good.
Poor Fazio comes off with clearly holding his shoulder in pain, and his teammate still puts the hand out, so he can still give me a high five, mate.
Give me high fives.
Whoop.
Dick your high five. Whoop. Fix my shoulder.
Gee, they got lucky to get out of that, the Tigers.
No, they're doing well. Kelly got in the back line there for Colac. Dishes it off to Simpkin. Running Simpkin, who looked good. They give it to him because he kicks well, apparently. Gives it to Learson. He did kick it well. Learson to Flekos. Just a half forward line for Colak and gives it to Carmody. Carmody, a bit far out for him. He doesn't like getting out that far, so he gives it to McGuan. Now, he's
stumping kick. You put this in the square, surely.
Well, could even go further if he really got onto
Seals
it.
Seals let out too far.
Looks to a short.
But he goes back. Jake.
Yep. So Carmody says, now I'm in a better range. I'll give it back to you, Jake. No,
it's on to Learson.
Learson will line up for his 50. Kicks this. It's bye-bye and off to the Empire Grill. So Learson, probably running a touch late, but that's okay. Was worth the start.
Can you start your car from here with that button, can you?
When he walks, Learson. And you can put him down. Look, if he kicks this, there's the three. Already got him down for three. He's played a great game, Kane Learson.
Oh, he's put it out on the full.
He has kicked it so far on the full. That is really great.
Look at that. We've got the 19th man's coming for you to go home. Good. Have a look at that. Mitch Cleary going to jump on board. So it's out in the full. Free kick. Looks like Benny Lavaz has taken it.
No, he's been. Ladies' Day.
Ladies' Day. He's done the Croc Media Report for Ladies' Day.
He's been here for Ladies' Day.
Does that mean Dan Janet was number one prize, Mitch Cleary's number two, is it?
Mitch Cleary is hosting the event.
Be something in there for Cleary, that's for bloody sure. He's always after a freebie on something.
So it's going to be thrown in. You've got Veal there, and also Stepton. Veal wins the tap, only as far as that Chisholm down there.
Oh, I reckon that was Devlin, wasn't it?
I'm not sure.
Neither. Close, Darcy.
Darcy's the bottom of the pack.
Or Dacey, as I've got it written. I've got to change that. Someone tell
Veal
me.
Wins it. Comes down. Comes out to Seal. Seal to Falekos. Falekos kicks it high and long.
It's
and
a for everybody.
McLean appealing for the mark. No mark there, though. The umpire was going to pay. He had the whistle in the mouth and nearly gave it to McCarthy, but couldn't get it. Falekos is back there now. Falekos over to Learson, just racking him up.
Oh, here he is. From the fence.
Here's his fifth.
From the fence. If you don't mind.
Yibbity yibbida. I'm off. Later. There's his fifth.
See you, mate. I'll see you later on. I'll see you for a frothy. Mitch Cleary, whack them on your head, son. And come and join us. He doesn't want to do it. Croc Media, not allowed.
Not in the contract.
Right in the contract. He's not allowed to. Once upon a time, you do that. Now he's too big for his up for us.
Hello, boys.
Mitch, how are you, mate? You might as well join us. It's an empty seat. You might as well sit down. Not that we want you, but, you know, it'll do. Your St Mary's boys not going that well, champ?
No, not too well. Plenty of young kids getting a game, which is good signs for the future. But
well, it's good signs for both sides. Colac's a very young side as well.
Absolutely.
Up we go again. This time Snowden wins it, knocks it down. Looks like Kelly, he's a brute in there. He just loves it. This mud's not going to bother him. But you were commenting on your support staff here. Gee, this is
very professional.
Very professional.
James Colbert's involved with the Drysdale Footy Club. And similar sort of
Grovedale, wasn't he?
Similar sort of group as well, the young guys, and turn them into a premiership winning side. So hopefully the same things can be done at St Mary's.
Is Mitch Cleary going to be a part of that future?
Oh, let's hope so. Got to go in the reserves first.
Loose ball, Carmody. Jake goes back, gets a good bounce here. He'll go to the left. As he does, sends centre forward for Jake. Oh, Learson has been. Can he get six? Goes with the right foot, puts it out in. Kiss by the rule. On the Seals direction, picks it up, wrapped up in a tackle, dispossessed. Boundary umpire says, we'll have a throw in.
I think it might even... No, I thought the umpire was coming in to call something there.
Learson and James Linton up there in the top two small forwards, half forwards in the competition at the moment together.
Both been fantastic.
Back to 10 points between Grovedale and South Bowen, boys. Just for your information, as McLean tries to crash his way through from centre-half back, off a step, Jake McGuan, but it's marked by Kyle Devlin. Back to 8 points, South Bowen and Grovedale. The other one is Newtown, 6 points, Newtown and St. Joey's. So a couple of close games there. Snowden, half-back, goes in the direction... Good roving by Condi. He goes at the back. Romain Grenville got a run here. Gets a good bounce. It's all over. Don't tell me he's missed that.
It's a coach killer. Jason Dunstall, coach killer.
He just... How often does Grenville do that?
Well, Grenville's shot from the social rooms to put it in the past player stand.
Why wouldn't you have just kicked that? He looked like he tried to make it look something special, and he's just...
Simpkin goes to the smallest man on the ground in Smart. Over to Sam Cardinal. Back to Smart. Back to Cardinal. Ducks the tackle. Then gives it over to Kelly. Hard working Andrew Kelly. Over to Lynch. Lynch down the line to Learson. Takes the mark. He's been fantastic, Learson. Again, off a step. Puts it in front of Jake McCarthy. Good dupes. Takes the mark. Gives it over to Monaghan. Goes forward, puts it out to Kears by the Rose, gives it over to the running Embry. Embry into the open goal, but it fades and hits the post. Mick Embry's first score for the day. They've been good, Colac. Right, you here right at the start?
Yeah, absolutely.
Gee, they started off like a house on fire, didn't they?
9 goals in that first quarter.
Gee whiz.
Some areas of they've done their best from what you could do from there, I guess you could put it.
The third quarter was very good.
Yeah.
We were seeing Colac 2 weeks in a row, and that seems to be what they do. They just get off to a flying start, and then they just do enough to keep it going.
Embry intercepts, but it's Condy who intercepts for St Mary's. Gives it over. We thought he was dead, this bloke. Fazio gives it over to Snowden, and then gets the advantage. It's paid to Etherton, but no advantage at all. I love that stuff. Free kick. What happened there? I thought he paid the advantage to St Mary's.
Fazio has no idea what's going on either.
Good mark there to Blacksall. It's picked up by Jake McGuan. Spots Learson out the corner of his eye. Learson pops it to his advantage. Good chase by Quinane. Learson up against the fence. No score. Throw in. 20 around from Colac goal.
Learson played a lot of footy in the Northern Territory over summer.
So did Linton. So they went up there together.
Shows a few boys in the same region might be trying the same things.
Yep. Colac's very cold. Comes out to Felikos. Felikos directly in front. Has he got another one? No, he hasn't.
What is that, Milky? Learson and possibly Learson's played, did you say, 2 consecutive years?
Learson's played 2 years of footy in a row without a break.
2 seasons, yeah. At a minimum.
And Linton's played 1. Is that right?
It's a handy pre-season.
Yeah.
A handy pre-season when you can go up there and do that. You're just looking at the Liverpool and Manchester United sides that are coming out. I know it's a long...
That's a massive show. This is massive.
They only have probably 4 to 6 weeks off in the off season.
Yep.
Our football is a little bit longer than that, so it shows it can be done.
Blacksall doing the. Haven't heard of this bloke before. I don't know where he's from.
Strong reserves player.
Yep. Oh, good fist away, boy. He's been really good, Veal. Off a step, but it's open that intercepts and takes the mark. Goes back to Embry, loves a run this bloke, gets around one, gets around two, then he turns just a little short kick to Jakey McGuan.
You nearly penciled this one in.
Mate, the man on the mark's only 45 out, and Tonks doesn't reckon the 50 St Mary's are 50.
I can put him through from here, I reckon.
Well, he's a thumping kick anyway, Jake.
I was actually reading one of your stories this week, Mitch. I can't remember what it was. What's the story you've written recently? It was a good one.
Plenty of those.
It was on the ASL website.
McGuan is going to drop in the square. McLean fists it over. For a minor score, yes. Put that down to rushed. Well, he's going through his stories. Look at him. He's going through his stories. Hang on. It's his vault opening.
I was trying to think what it was. I was going to send you a message and say it was a good one. But
it would have been on the ladies' day at St Mary's. You watched me cut a couple of... Cut a sway through them.
Dermot Burton on Buddy Franklin. Is that the one?
Oh, Learson, the kick out.
Yeah, it could have been actually.
Learson takes the mark against the flow. There was 4 St Mary's blokes in the traffic. Against the flow, Learson takes the mark. He has been sensational. Play on, the umpire is called. Freddie Stepnan gets around him. Kelly sorts him out. Oh, throws a boot at him. Did you see that?
What happened?
Freddie was laying on the ground, threw his boot at Kelly. Hebbard gets one high. I know his parents, in case you didn't know. You haven't heard that. They've been giving it to me all day. Over to Will McGregor. Good kick into space. Josh Eddy, who's certainly in their best three, goes to ground, though, unfortunately. Bolsh gets some help here from Foss. Goes back to Veal. Taps it forward. Then gets it again. Bolsh again. Picked off here by McCarthy. In turn, goes to Lynch. Lynch off a step. He's got Linton in the middle of 2 St Mary's players. Geez, good player this Linton.
He was away there, Linton.
Yeah, of course he was. Don't let him stand still.
How old is he, Brownie?
He's only 22 or 23.
Look who he's gone to.
He's
picked him out.
He's probably only 22 or 23 old, I'd say, in the world that doesn't have a mobile phone.
Really?
Well, that's what, after the Interleague game, we tried to get onto him because he left straight away to go down to the Dreamtime game.
Yep.
And we said to Wally, do you have his number? And he said, you'll have to call his parents because he doesn't have a mobile.
Well, we. A few VFL clubs might be after asking him to get a mobile.
Yeah. They'll probably give it to him to pay the bill.
Because I think there's one that might have already teed that up.
Yep. This Simpkin's been good too. It's been very good for him. Yeah, look at fresh face on him. He's only lucky to be 18 by the look of him. He goes to the outer side. They like him using the footy. Found his teammate in Fedley.
Both guys, Simpkin is 19, same as Cole Dillon, both sort of playing that quarterback role at either end.
Yep.
Same age.
Showing the ways, Mitch, that
found Learson.
Simpkin out there is the best of the three. Would that be right?
For Lekos, Jake Carmody crashes into the pack.
Strong bloodlines, but...
Marnie gets it over by hand to Kelly. Strong bloodlines, I'd reckon. Oban on the run. He's got Seal, I think that is. No, it's not. Who is that going forward? That's Rowan.
He's got plenty of time on his hands to get it to a VFL club and follow the same path as Jonathan. Jonathan did the same. He was playing like senior footy at that same age.
Yeah, absolutely. They're a good family too. The Simpkins.
Yeah, his brother makes a return to our Saints this weekend.
Here he comes, Rowan. We got a good look at this one, but he's tugged it to the left. Minor score, no problem with the distance. It's his first score for the day. Tigers are home, by the way. Don't worry about that. There's no chance of a late charge here from St Mary's. Let me quickly look at the others. 10 points, South Bowen trail 6-15 to 9-7.
Is that?
10 points in both games. 10 points Grovedale lead South Bowen. 10 points Newtown lead St Joseph's.
Is South Bowen heading for their first?
Could be.
First defeat.
I don't think they've had been in front at all day. Ball comes out. Condy takes a mark almost in front of the Street Surfer bus. He decides to go, well, I think he was going to Lavaz, but it's picked off by Cardinal, who in turn gives it over to Rowan. Rowan has a bounce and then goes towards the goal squares. Two on one. Learson's got two to beat. But it's Seal has leads in the race, but the boundary wins it and will have a throw in.
Pretty massive if Grovedale get up.
Yeah.
I see that they haven't been in the best of form. They've been winning, but they haven't been in the best of form.
I'll be celebrating out there at Alberta Reserve tonight if they get up out there.
Give an excuse to Grant Tanner to get on it.
Oh, he's just let that go. Just let that go, your man in Darcy. Good chase by Sammy Cardinal. Not sure if he's taking my niece out or not anymore. He used to. I don't know if he still does.
Do you approve?
I think he found out I was the uncle, so he dumped her.
Had nothing. Watching the replays of the footy and had enough of you.
Sammy Cardinal, man on the marks. 40, 38 out, comes in. He's not even going to make the distance. Up they go, Snowden and McLean. One of them gets ahead of it. Snowden, was he pinched from was it pinched from his hands? Blacksall gives it over to Darcy. Darcy off a step into centre. Veal should mark this. Josh Eddy, he's got the two grabs, Veal, but not paid. Eddie's got him wrapped up in a tackle. Out the back to Fazio. Free kick going surely St Mary's way to Justin Foss. Foster side, he was coming over here to Devlin, but he decides in the end to go over to Darcy. Darcy with a left foot long. Ryan Grenville, one grab, two grabs, three grabs, Linton's gone in to help out. Ball knocked forward, free kick going against, free kick, who was that against? It must have been to Linton, so.
Against Nolan.
Yeah.
Adam Skinny Nolan.
Yep. From Simpkin over to Bolsh. Bolsh, little chip. Finds his mate in Monaghan. Monaghan goes looking for Learson. Doesn't let him down. Doesn't take the mark. He's hurt his opponent. Hurt him big time. Snowy's in all sorts of pain. In the middle of that, comes out Finn Chisholm. Goes forward. One on three. And he's there. Romaine! That's a bit of a half a look at me. Snowy, in a lot of pain in front of us here though. That's the.
Have I been missing this all day with Grenville getting the footy?
No, actually, it's been pretty quiet with Grenville. He talks himself up enough, so we don't always talk him up. Just every now and again.
He was dodging his shadow here before he ran around. There was no one anywhere near him. He's doing dodging and weaving. Sensational. This for his first major Wouldn't be too many weeks go by where he hasn't kicked a goal, would there?
If he gets onto this, he'll just about put it in the pool. He's that big of a kick.
And he comes.
Oh.
Unloads. Nearly put in the pool, all right.
Look at him, they clap him, they get around him. He was getting into him before when they did the same thing.
he does enjoy and chat, put a chat on the field.
Not snowy. It seems to be moving okay, but I reckon he got a knee right in the back from Learson.
Yeah, it didn't look like it tickled.
Now Embry comes out, but it's intercepted by Faziel. Tiger boy's not happy. Faziel will have the return shot on goal. See where these games are at. Grovey and South Bowen, 18 minute mark. Got another goal, Grovey.
Did they?
Yeah, it's out to 15 points.
Shit. I actually didn't think South Bowen would get beaten this year.
Newtown and Joey's is back to 8 points. So, goal to Fazio, by the way.
He's another one of these St Mary's guys that's toured away in the reserves for a couple of years after playing in Rodan's footy. Mm-hmm. Just starting to get his chance. AJ Davey. Matt Craig not playing today. Scott Condy has done the same thing. He's come over from Newtown with his older brother Rob, and yes, good group of 19 and sort of 21 year olds getting a chance at senior footy at St Mary's at the moment.
He always seems to, every time I speak to him, he's pretty confident about the future.
That's right, yeah.
You know, he's probably not a bad coach to have trying to build up a side.
Absolutely, and helps him when you've got a few VFL guys from over the road.
Yeah, it helps, but also they pinch him on you, don't they? Smart gets it to Falekos. Falekos going to get round McLean. Decides to go up and over him. Jake McGuan. Oh, just good use of the body there against Blacksall. Strong. And don't worry about the distance here. This will go through post high. And it's just a matter of accuracy.
McGuan's been reasonably busy today, but he could have had a day out. He's kicked 2 goals 4 at this
stage.
Yes,
exactly.
So this, you'd think, make it 3 goals 4.
And after the siren, he's going to kick. So it's at this stage, it's 40 points. It is now going to be 46. 41? 46.
46, I think.
40. Come on, goal umpire. 46. Gets the goal. For his third. 3-4. Good game of footy, boys. But it was all first quarter where the Tigers, 9 goals 2-1 behind, was all she wrote from there. Wasn't it?
Which is just pointed out there that Ben Jennings hobbling off with the ice pack on the
shin. It's not the knees. It's not high enough up.
That. Yeah. He did come off a few times today with like a bit of an injury. So
that's just a typical Ruckman's injury.
Tonks was saying that he was the raffle in the ladies' day. That's why he had to keep going off and on. He's got a sixth sense of humour, that bloke. He's a sixth sense of humour, that bloke. Seriously.
You look at the score now. Ooh. If you know, it's basically the start. The first quarter was the difference in the match. You know, after that, St Mary's really came into it.
Oof.
You cut back that first quarter and it's...
Just quickly, Grovedale have gone out to 20 points.
20 points up.
Newtown and St Joseph's back to 2 points.
Whose way?
Newtown, 15-minute mark. So plenty of time, I mean, nothing could happen there.
Fingers crossed St Joe's get up. Good to see.
Young side, Leopold and St Albans.
So you'd almost...
Back to 9 points.
Pencil Grovedale in for that win. That's huge.
Oh, it's a 21.5-minute mark at... 20 points up, it's over. That's a win, no doubt about that.
Well, did South Bowen have a few out this week, did they, or are they just...
I don't think it's the most, one of the most difficult things ever to go through undefeated. It's a tough trick.
Not the worst problem to have on it.
No, exactly right.
One defeat.
Ocean Grove in the race. 10 points up on Bowen Heads in the last quarter. Keeping their faint sniff alive. Drysdale are comfortable over Amos. 22 points.